Now, electric field due to a dipole on its equatorial line. So this is your equatorial line, means the line joining the perpendicular bisector. So if this is the perpendicular bisector, with any point on this line, we call it equatorial line. So we have to find electric field due to this dipole at a distance r from the center of the dipole lying on the perpendicular bisector of the dipole. So is it clear? So this is your figure. This is your plus Q charge, this is your minus Q charge, and they are separated by a distance 2L. So this length will be L, and obviously this length will be L. This distance is R. So electric field due to this positive charge will act in this direction, that is away from the charge. So this is E. And for this charge, electric field will act towards the charge, as I told you earlier. So it is also E. If we break this into two components, we will have, if this angle is theta, this is going to be theta, that is corresponding angle. And if this angle is theta, this angle is also theta, that is alternate angle. So if we break this field E in two parts, here we will have E sin theta and here we will have E cos theta. Similarly, for this field, we will have two components. One is horizontal, that is E cos theta, and one is vertical, that is E sin theta. Is it clear? So E sin theta and E sin theta will get cancelled. So your net field will be, net field, I am writing E prime because already I have used E. So your net field will be E prime is equal to 2E cos theta. Simple. So what is your E? E is K Q divided by separation square. So if you what is the separation between that point where I am asking for the field and the dipole, the distance separation is XB. And what is your XB? This is your R, this is your L. So it is going to be XB square into cos theta. What is your cos theta? Cos theta is B by H. B by H. So your B is L. And what is your H? H is your again XB. So it is XB cube. So it is going to be K twice L Q divided by XB square. Your XB square is your hypotenuse square. If this is a right angle triangle, XB is your hypotenuse. So XB square is going to be R square plus L square. Simple. This is your XB square from Pythagoras theorem into L. I have written here. Again, one XB is left. And XB, what will be the XB? It is going to be under root R square plus L square. Again, since L is very, very small in comparison to R, L square can be neglected. L square can be neglected. So if L square is neglected, we will put 0 in place of L square. So your net field E prime is equal to K. And for twice L cube, we can write P, dipole moment. And it is R square. L square is neglected. So it is going to be R square into, again L square is neglected, it is under root R square. So under root R square is R. Your under root R square is R. So final result is your E, K, P by R cube. So your field on the equatorial line is KP by RQ, and your direction of that field is towards the left or towards the negative charge. Now, if you want to find the relation between E prime, this field, and E earlier, which we have found in axial line, so this is double of this, that was twice KP RQ. So, if that was E, your final result is here. So, we can write, this is your final result. that is electric field due to dipole of its equatorial point, a point lying on the equatorial line. And there is a relation between field in axial point and field at an equatorial point. So this field of field in the axial line is double of this. Field in the axial line, mind it, you can check last video. Here the field, in last video the field was twice kp r cube. So if you multiply this electric field by 2, you get the field in the axial line. Right? So this much was, this is the thing you have to learn and you have to understand. And very important question, that how to find electric field on this equatorial point, and your result is kp by r cube.